What's going on, everyone? Jeremy here from The Quartering. And once in a while, I have a very important topic, and it's one that I'll ask you to share around. Today is just one of those days. In addition to the normal afternoon show where I kind of do a wrap up, sometimes issues that are so important must stand alone in their own video. This video is going to cover what is potentially a very, very slippery slope taking place in Australia right now, but it will affect the UK, the United States, and potentially everybody else out there in terms of their data and personal information security. Okay, so the 30,000 foot view is there is a legislation that is up for vote on September 10th, 2018, so just 4 days from today, where essentially the government will put the onus on telecommunications companies to build in backdoor options for the government to get in and read your data, access your data without a warrant. If they refuse to comply, there are fines as big as $10 million, including for people whistleblowing on this. And so I have a feeling that's why this is criminally underreported. If you search Google for videos on the Assistance and Access Bill, or known better as ASS Access.
Unfortunately, encryption makes it hard for us to spy on you these days. So just to make sure, we're introducing yet another law to expand the surveillance state. Introducing the Assistance and Access Bill, or ASS Access for short.
You'll find just a few videos on the topic, and I'm convinced it's because places like the UK and Australia prosecute for whistleblowing on some of their most abhorrent behavior. So I'm going to go through a couple of the articles. It's a complex issue, but in general, I think you'll get a good idea of what we're facing here. So the providers will be required. These are telecommunication providers. This is YouTube. This is Facebook. This is any app that you like, Snapchat, right? They will be required to develop new ways for law enforcement to collect information, as in the UK. It's not clear whether a provider will be able to offer true end-to-end encryption and still be able to comply with the notices. Providers that breach the law risk facing $10 million fines. The bill puts few limits or constraints on assistance that telecommunication providers may be ordered to offer. There's also concerns about transparency. The bill would make it an offense to disclose information about government agency activities without authorization, meaning if the government accesses your information, your Facebook data, your YouTube data, your Snapchat data, your banking data, these companies can't even tell you about it without facing up to a $10 million fine. This differs from how it works in the UK, where a specific judicial oversight regime is established because there is limited oversight and accountability structures in and processes in place. The Director General of Security, the Chief Officer of the Interception Agency, and the Attorney General can issue notices without judicial oversight. The range of service providers is also extremely broad. It might include telecommunications companies, internet service providers, email providers, social media platforms, and a range of, quote, other over-the-top services. It also covers those who develop, supply, or update software and manufacture, supply, install, or maintain data processing devices. The enforcement of criminal laws in other countries mean that international requests for data will be funneled through Australia as its weakest link. This is really important. So if you're wondering right now, it's in Australia, sucks for them. No, what's going to happen is they will enforce this law inside of Australia to get at your data if you're a citizen of the UK, if you're a citizen of the United States, because in Australia, they don't have a Bill of Rights. So this is important. This affects more than simply the Australian citizens. It affects anybody because the data will simply be funneled through there. That means if you're in Canada, if you're in New Zealand, if you're in the United Kingdom, if you're in the USA, any one of the Five Eyes, including Australia.
Which is why to test this shit fuckery, we chose Australia, the weakest of the Five Eyes Alliance, thanks to our lack of a Bill of Rights. So international data requests will now be funneled through us, compromising not just Aussies, but all of you fuckers too. You're welcome.
Your data will be funneled through Australia in order to provide a weak point where the government can then get at your data. This is a very real bill. It is really up for vote. It's not clear how the government would enforce these laws on a transnational in technology companies. For example, if Facebook was issued a fine under these laws, it could simply withdraw operations or refuse to pay. Also, $10 million is a drop in the ocean for companies such as Facebook, whose total revenue last year exceeded $40 billion. Australia already has limited human rights and privacy protections, and this only further expands it. Now, what can you do about it? Well, the Digital Rights Watch has a great video, by the way, which hilariously explains just how frightening this is. It uses satire to really drive it home. But they've released a draft of a bill designed to compel device managers and service providers to assist law enforcement in accessing encrypted information. Although apparently developed to allow government agencies to access to criminals' encrypted communications, the bill also grants broad sweeping powers to government agencies that will harm the security and stability of our communication and the internet at large. This really reminds me of when we had the Patriot Act in the United States. This is an absolute erosion of our civil liberties. And this website, which I'll link in the description, actually has a way to a form letter that you can fill out and get at the bill creators, letting them know your displeasure. Now, I would suggest maybe changing this part of it, adding your own thoughts, and maybe including their form letter, because you know it'll be really easy for them to ignore if they get hundreds of the same or thousands of the same form letters. But I'm going to let Baring know about this, everybody in the UK, because they're our first line, or in Australia, because this is clearly our first and best line of defense against this bill. But this matters if you're in Canada, the United States, the UK, anywhere in the world, because as this expands out, we're just exchanging more of our civil liberties in exchange for these nebulous, it's for your own good type promises from the government. Now, maybe it's just a bill that needs to be revised, but in its current state, it does not provide any specifics around how it's going to affect everyday citizens, how it will be used by the government. And there are three main concerns. One, it creates obligations on technology company producers and communication providers, forcing them to work with law enforcement agencies. It creates powers that would allow police to seize information directly from a device, and it allows government operatives to access more data through current warrants, meaning we have really no knowing of how broadly this will be enforced. I know that once these things are in place, they're almost impossible to overturn. So this is an important video. This is an important video to spread around, to make your own videos. If you want to mirror this video, go ahead. I don't care. This is a message that needs to get spread, and it needs to get talked about before September 10th, when the draft gets voted on. So if you have any questions, the links in the description will probably help you understand a little bit more. There are plenty of resources out there on the Digital Rights Watch. So this is pretty creepy stuff. I hope that we can stand up and defend our rights to use data encryption. Hope you enjoyed this video. We'll talk to you again real soon.
To bring you us access, we've taken the UK's fascist spying law and made it even more fascist by removing any need for judicial oversight. But don't worry, we promise to only spy on you if reasonable and proportionate.